walks across the field. A boy gets off the roundabout. Everyone leaves. Harry sits on a swing, lost in thought. He sees his cousin Dudley with his can.
Hey, Big D. Beat up another 10-year-old.
This one deserved it.
Yeah. Five against one. Very brave.
Well, you're one to talk. Moaning in your sleep every night. At least I'm not afraid of my pillow. Don't kill Cedric. Who said your boyfriend?
Shut up.
He's going to kill me, Mum. Where is your mum? Where is your mum, Potter? Is she dead? Is she dead? She's dead, Potter.
Harry pulls out his wand. He holds it at Dudley's throat. The sky grows dark. Heavy storm clouds roll overhead, blotting out the sun. A strong wind rises.
What's going on? What are you doing?
I'm not doing anything. Get out of here, Dudley.
The storm runs off. Dudley and Harry look up as the sky grows even darker. The powerful wind blows flurries of waste paper across the playground. They run for shelter as the storm breaks and heavy rain begins to fall. Harry leads the way along a rutted cart track. Dudley is overweight and finds it hard to keep up. Soaked to the skin, they find shelter in a long tunnel under the road. They stop to catch their breath. Ahead of them, the grimy underpass is dimly lit by yellow lamps reflected in the puddles of water underfoot. The faulty lamps flicker and fizz, throwing an eerie yellow light along the tunnel. The dingy concrete walls are covered with graffiti. They look around nervously, their breath visible in the icy air. A cloaked figure swoops in and grabs Harry.
Dudley, run!
As Dudley flees, his legs are knocked from under him. An unseen force drags him along the ground. A second skeletal figure floats close above his face. Dementor hovers in front of Harry, forcing him against the wall with its bony fingers around his throat, attempting to suck out his life. Harry struggles desperately as a faint vapor is drawn from his face. The second Dementor floats above Dudley, sucking vapor from him. Harry pulls out his wand and strikes his attacker. The Dementor releases him. Harry falls heavily, dropping his wand. He grabs it as the cloaked figure swoops again. A powerful bright light hurls his attacker away. Dudley lies helpless beneath the other Dementor. Harry uses his wand to hurl the dazzling light towards it. The creature flies from the underpass. Traffic roars past on the road above. Harry runs to Dudley, who is semi-conscious and gasping for breath. An elderly woman wearing a plastic Mac and rain hat enters the tunnel, bringing a shopping trolley.
Miss Spick!
Harry tries to hide his wand. The old woman stops.
Stop drawing your wand, Harry. They might come back.
They walk home.
Dementors are a little whingy. Whatever next? The whole world's topsy-turvy.
I don't understand. How do you know about...
Dumbledore asked me to keep an eye on you.
Dumbledore? You know Dumbledore?
How do you know who killed that old dingy boy last year? Did you expect him to let you go wandering around on your own? Good lord, boy. They told me you were intelligent. Now, get inside and stay there. Spend some room being told soon. Whatever happens, don't leave the house.
Harry half carries the stupefied Dudley to number 4 Privet Drive. Petunia is watching television.
It is hot. That's right, hot everywhere. There's sweat, there's stifling. Sun is just burning down.
Is that you?
Harry staggers in with Dudley.
Dudley, Vernon, come quick. I'm going to have to take him to hospital.
Who did this to you, boy?
About to be sick, Dudley points weakly at Harry.
Happy, are we, now? Eh? You've finally done it. You've finally driven him loopy. Just look at it, Petunia. Our boy has gone yumpy. I've reached my limit. You hear? This is the last I'm going to take of you. What? You're nonsense.
An owl hits the ceiling and falls in a flurry of feathers. letter marked confidential floats in the air. The owl flies off. The envelope speaks.
Dear Mr. Potter, the ministry has received intelligence that at 6:23 this evening, you performed the Patronus charm in the presence of a muggle as a clear violation of the decree for the reasonable restriction of underage sorcery. You are hereby expelled from Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. Hoping you are well, Mathilda Hopker.
Uncle Vernon smirks with glee.
Justice!
Under cover of darkness, the Dursleys smuggle Dudley into the car with a blanket over his head. Mrs. Fig watches from her window opposite. Mrs. Fig waves. Uncle Vernon mouths he's not very well. In his bedroom,